Technical analysis is the study of the behavior of the markets. So in order to do so, we have to understand supply and demand. So the first thing that we should do is define what these things are. If you follow me here, let's talk about support. Okay, we've mentioned it a few times so far in this educational series, but I think it's really important to recognize that support, demand, buying, those are all the same things. They're synonyms. So when you hear the word support, these are levels where a falling market stops to decline, right? There comes a point where the amount of selling that's taking place in a downtrend gets overwhelmed by the buyers. That's support, where that price falling ends and then begins a phase of appreciation in price. In the future, when markets return to that former level of support where the buyers came in and it turns into support again, that is further evidence of the importance of that level. The more times that a level is tested, the more significant that level should become in the future. So that's what we're watching. Resistance is the exact opposite. Resistance, selling, overhead supply, these are all the same things. They're synonyms. And what resistance is this is the level where prices in an uptrend stop appreciating. There comes a level where the amount of buying taking place gets overwhelmed by that overhead supply, and those are the peaks in the market. So when the market rolls over and then returns to that former peak, that resistance, that overhead supply steps in and reiterates that that level is resistance. That level is run by the sellers, not by the buyers. Ultimately, when prices break out above resistance, that is a bullish development. When prices break below support, that is a bearish development. Guys, this is supply and demand 101.